Thank you for watching, and in this chapter we are going to cover how we can make drawings from the assemblies. And in this video I am going to tell you how you can create your drawing from this assembly. So to creating a drawing from the assembly, what we need to do is we can add some balloons, we can add some material insights, and then we can add some notes, and then we can explain actually how to mount or how to just pack the assembly parts. So no, we don't need to give a lot of dimensions, as we are gonna give into the parts drawing, where we need to focus on the dimensions, like what are the sizes and what are the dimensions. But in the assembly drawings we need to explain the whole procedure, how things will be gathered and how you need to pack the whole assembly. So as for example, I have this assembly right now here. So what I want to do is I want to go into the file, and then you can see there is the option make drawing from the assembly. So I'm gonna go here, and then I need to choose a template. So if you have a template, then you can go into the advanced, and then you can choose template whatever you want. Or if you want to go with the default template, so then you can just select the default template and then you can click OK. And then as this is the basic drawing, like whenever you are gonna open the drawing and whenever you are not gonna choose any template, so you would see this pop up. So you need to choose the sheet size, what kind of sheet you want to choose, what is the size, and if you want to change the custom size, like if you want to have some custom size, you can have a custom size, or if you already have some sheet in your PC, so you can browse and you can bring that sheet design, or if you want to change the size, width, height, you can change from here. So I'm gonna fine with the A3 one, and then I'm gonna click OK. As into the part environment, we saw in the videos, like when we are gonna move into the drawing, so we would see all possible views on the right side. So same in the case assemblies, as you can see, we have all those views which are possible for our assembly. So right now here is a front view, right view, top view, back view, left, bottom, isometric, and much more. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna bring this front view here. And then as soon as I'm dropping my front view here, so you can see when I'm gonna go back onto the right side, so then what I can do is I can insert my right view here. And if I'm gonna move a bit up, so you can see I can draw my isometric view here, or in this way, what I can do is I can draw my back view. Or if I'm gonna go onto the left side or downside, so we can insert some other views as well. And then what I can do is I can click green check mark. Sorry for distraction, but if you think my videos are helpful for you, or if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, I am gonna highly recommend you can go into the description of this video, where you can find my course link, in which I have over 10 hours of videos in which I explain each and every command in a detailed way. Thank you. Okay, there is another thing, like because this is the first view, and all those other views are the projection from this view. So by moving this view, what we can do is we can move all other views, as you can see, but not the isometric one. And there is another thing, like if I'm gonna change the shade or if I'm gonna change the style, so all the projections is gonna move into that style. Or if I'm gonna go into some wireframe or whatever the style I can go, so I can just go in them. And then you can see all the projections having the same update. I'm gonna click the green check mark. Or if you want to change the style of some specific projection, so what you can do, you can just select it and then you can go into that. And then you can do whatever the modification you want to do on that specific projection. But the view is looking to me a bit shorter. So what I would like to do is I would right click on here and then I would go into the properties. Actually, I want to increase the ratio. This is my point. Like I was thinking that maybe there is some problem in the ratio. So I want to increase the ratio 1:2 to 1:1:1. And then I'm going to apply the changes. So in this way, as you can see, my views are a bit bigger than before. So this is what I want. And then I'm going to click the green check mark. Okay. So the next thing is, like, if I want to have an exploded view, because like this is not a part drawing, this is an assembly drawing, so we need to explain how to combine all those parts. So what I need to do is I would take this isometric view, I would select this view, and then I'm gonna press Ctrl C, And then I'm going to click anywhere and then I can control V. So I can just paste it. So right now, as you can see, I have this isometric view. So if I am on this isometric view and if I'm going to select this view, then you can see there is an option like we can have an exploded view. So what I can do is, as you can see into the feature manager, I have option show in exploded or model break state. So I'm going to check this and then you can see. So this is the exploded view. So in that way, what we can do is we can just define how you need to build our assembly. So in that way, we can explain, or what we can do is we can add some balloons, we can add some nodes. So as I already mentioned, like this is an assembly, this is not a part. So that's why we are not going to focus on the dimensions. Into the part assembly, we need to focus on dimensions. What are the dimensions or what are the features of that part? But the parts are already built. So this is an assembly. So we just want, we have all those parts and we want to send it to the machine lab or wherever. So they are going to just combine all those parts and make a final product. And that's all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one. And if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, then don't forget to check the course link in the description. Thank you.